Hello everyone, in this video I am going to show you how to clone your existing C drive into your newly purchased disk with bootable features. Currently I have Netac 2TB NVMe SSD and I have just purchased Samsung 99 Pro with Heatsink 4TB and I am going to clone my existing C drive into this new Samsung drive by using open source Clonezilla. Clonezilla is an open source disk imaging and cloning software. It is totally free to use, so this tutorial will be valid every time whenever you are watching this. Just click this download section here, and in here we are going to download a disk image where we can write into the flash disk. You need to have a USB disk for this to work, and then we will start that USB disk from the BIOS. Click this stable 3.1.2 version in here. Make sure that you have selected AMD 64. Download as a ISO file from here and click download. Then we are going to burn this ISO file into the USB disk by using Rufus. So just type Rufus to your browser, go to the downloads of Rufus and download the portable exe from here. I will put the links of these files into the description of the video, so don't worry about that. And we can see both files are downloaded. Let's open Rufus. Okay, click no. Then select your USB device from here. Select your downloaded ISO from here, which is Clonezilla. Then you don't need to change anything. Everything is ready. Just start. This will burn this ISO file into the USB so we can boot our Clonezilla in the BIOS. You will see that it is pretty fast. So these settings are extremely important. They are automatically set. Make sure that you are using the same settings when burning ISO into the USB disk. Okay, everything is ready. Now I need to just mount my newly purchased disk into my motherboard and start from USB from BIOS. I will switch to the BIOS recording right now. Okay, now I am going to enter the boot menu with the F12, and in here I am going to select my SanDisk, which is my USB disk, as you are seeing. So after we generated the USB disk, we need to enter the boot menu. Right now on the left part of the screen, you will see that there is these options. In here I am going to select the Clonezilla Live VGA with large font and to RAM option, the third option. Then you will see that it will start loading like this. Okay, since my monitor is very big, it is displaying like this, but I am just going to select English and hit enter. Then I am just going to hit enter, keep the default keyboard layout, then it will get fixed in a moment. Okay, now start following me very carefully. Start Clonezilla. In here we are going to select device to device, the second option, which is extremely important because we are going to clone our device into another device. Then it will scan all of the disks at the left bottom of the screen. You can see that it is finding all disks, finding all partitions. You may also get some error or warning messages. They are not important. Okay, in this screen we are going to select expert, don't you worry. In here we are going to select disk to local disk, local disk to local disk clone. Do not select part to local part, local partition to local partition. Select disk to local disk, local disk to local disk clone. So the first option select with enter, then it will find all disk and partitions at the left bottom of the screen. You can see that. Okay, now we are going to select the source disk. When you read the choose local disk as source, you will understand that you are selecting this source disk, which is our C drive in this case. So my C drive is the Netac. The second disk, it may be different in your case. Make sure that you have selected the accurate source disk. This is super important. So I am going to select the Netac as my source disk. Then you will see on the left bottom finding all disk and partitions. Now you will see choose local disk as target. This is extremely important. It says that all data on the entire disk will be lost. So this is our new disk the disk that we are going to move our existing disk into the new one. So this will be my new disk. This is 4 TB Samsung SSD 990 Pro. So I am going to select this disk as my target disk. So this is choose local disk as target. This is super important. So in this screen, do not change anything. Just hit OK. This is super important. In this screen, also you don't need anything. Just say skip checking repairing source file system. Okay, this screen is also super important. This is the advanced parameter that we are going to set, as you can see. So in this screen, we are going to select create partition table proportionality. What does this mean? This means that since our source disk is 2 TB and our target disk is 4 TB, we have to expand the partition table. So in this case, select create partition table proportionally, which is the option 3. This is super important. Do not skip this part. And in here, in this case, I will choose reboot, shutdown, etc. when everything is finished, because I want to see everything what is happened. So I will select this option. Then it will ask you enter to continue on the left bottom. Then it will show you one more time that did you select the disks accurately. So it says that warning, the existing data in this hard disk partitions will be overridden. Which one? So it shows which ones will be overridden. It is displaying me that 4 TB Samsung SSD 990 Pro. It is accurate. I am going to delete all the data on the 990 Pro, which is the new disk, with the information from my C drive. Verify everything and then hit yes key. It is asking you to do that and hit enter. Then it will ask you one more time to be sure. Are you sure that you want to delete all the data on the Samsung SSD 990 Pro? I am sure. So I am going to hit yes and hit enter. Then it will start the cloning the disk. The amazing part of Clonezilla is that it is totally free. So whenever you are watching this video, it should work. After a while, you will start seeing the cloning progress like this case. It is pretty fast since my both of the disks are extremely fast disks. Currently, my cloning speed is 72.5 gigabytes per minute. So this is per minute speed. So per second, it is over 1.5 gigabytes per second. The cloning has been completed, and there is one very crucial step that I suggest you to do. As you see, it says remember to remove the source disk or the cloned destination disk before you boot this machine. Otherwise, when two identical systems exist on the same machine, the restored operating system will be confused and booting might fail. Therefore, now I am going to remove the original disk and boot into the Windows, verify everything. Then I will mount back again my other disk and go to the BIOS and set the booting device. So with this way, I will be able to utilize both of the disks at the same time. So after you hit enter at that screen, you will see power off, which I am going to do. Before I continue into the Windows, there is extremely one more crucial thing. In the BIOS, you have to set the new cloned disk as a first booting disk from the drive option priorities, or you have to put it into the place of the original disk. Otherwise, you won't be able to boot up with the new cloned disk. Currently, I am not able to set driver option priorities because in my motherboard, I have to use VMD setup for RAID storage technology. Therefore, I switched the places with the new disk and the old disk. So in the first slot of my motherboard, there is the new SSD right now. Therefore, the BIOS is booting up the system with the newly cloned disk. I also did set the boot manager for the new disk. This took me many hours to figure out, so I am giving you this extremely crucial information before we continue start using both of the disks at the same time on the Windows.
So the Windows has started and now we are ready to use both of the disks. However, the older C drive is not visible or available right now because it is by default set to the offline disk by the Windows when booting. So we go to the computer management, storage, disk management as usual, and in here we are going to make it online from here. So set it online. By the way, I suggest you to format this disk to not have any confliction. However, Before formatting it, you should verify whether all of the files are accurately copied or not. For this verification, I have a self-developed C# application. It is fully multi-threaded and working amazing. The link of this post will be in the description of the video. The link contains both compiled .exe file and the full source code. So let's download the full source code to be able to show you the source code and how to use it. For downloading the source code, click here. It will start downloading the source code. I will extract it into my another disk so there won't be unnecessary files when comparing. Just double click the .sln file. You need to have Visual Studio installed to start and run this application with C#. You can see the entire source code in here. All you need to do is just start it, then enter the source path and the destination path. Let me show you. By the way, I will start as administrator, so let's open the folder, enter inside debug. For these files to be generated, you need to one time start it or right click and rebuild the solution. And in here, right click and run as administrator. So I did start it as administrator, which was my original disk. It was local drive F. So enter here F and the destination is C. And then all you need to do is just click start verification. First of all, it will fetch all of the files in both of the disks. This program has continue feature, so you can close it and start verification again. It will skip the files that it has already compared. Right now it is reading all of the files and folders from both of the disks. So we need to just wait a little bit until the software read all of the file structure in both of the disks to start comparing them. So it started comparison. It fetched all of the files in both of the disks. It says that there are 445 not having elements. So let's see them. You will see there are generated text files here, byte compared files list. It will use this as tracking the number of files compared or not. Then you will see that there are error bytes not matching list. This is the list that will show you not accurately cloned files or corrupted. You will see file read errors. Some files may not be available to read, such as these ones. And you will see first folder does not have. This means that the first disk does not have these files, which are, as you can see, recycle bin files, and there are also some program files. Probably these were all generated after I restarted my computer, as you can see. So none of these are important files. As you can see, these are all Microsoft Office updates, and these are the logs. So there are no missing files after our cloning. It worked perfectly. Now all I need to just wait is bytes check completed and bytes check non-matching. If the non-matching is zero, that means the cloning was 100% successful and we cloned everything very accurately. The file verification has been completed. There are only 252 non-matching files, and I checked them and these are all actively modified files, such as these ones. So there are no issues. Therefore, now I am going to delete the entire partition of the previous C drive, which is now F drive, and prevent further confliction with my new C drive, and I will be able to use the older drive as a new drive. The regular format will not work. Therefore, we have to delete the partitions. So let's take the disk offline. To delete the partitions of that disk, we have to use DiskPart. So to do that, start a command window with administrator. So run as administrator. Then we need to first move to the DiskPart. So I type DiskPart like this. Follow me carefully. Then we will do list disk, and you will see that the offline disk is 4, which is my currently only offline disk. I can see that here disk 4 is offline. Also, the number is matching here. Make sure that you are selecting the accurate disk. Then what I need to do is select that disk with select disk 4. Then I can list the partitions or do a clean. Let's list the partitions, list partition. And you see there are 3 partitions: recovery, system and reserve it. And we can verify whether it is accurate or not. When we check the partitions, we see there are three partitions and it is looking accurate. Then what I need to do is just type clean command and it will delete all of the partitions. Okay, it says that we have to take it back to the online. So let's make it online. Then let's try clean again. Okay, it says that it was successful and yes, all of the partitions are deleted. Now what I'm going to do is initialize disk like this. Okay. And select new volume. Give any letter you wish. Let's make it F. Let's make it as Netac 2 TB. And finish. And now we have the Netac disk, which was my original disk, as a clean zeroed disk like this. As a last step, I have compared both of the disks speeds with Crystal Disk Mark. You see the new Samsung SSD 990 Pro with heatsink is able to get 7 GB per second reading, 7 GB per second writing. These are the test results as you are seeing. And the Netac 2 TB is able to almost get same speeds. So both of the disks are working in excellence. I hope you have enjoyed. I tried to give you a lot of information and it took me like a day to record this video because I had a lot of issues during the initialization due to my RAM setup or other stuff. Hopefully see you in future amazing tutorials.